Hey everyone, this is Jason Robinson from Illustration by Design, and today I'm going to demonstrate how I preserve comics in MyLite bags. I usually use MyLite bags, which are, well, hold on, let me show you. MyLites are these. They're Mylar, thin Mylar bags, which are acid-free, and the protective Mylar bags to preserve comic books and other periodical paper items within so that they don't yellow or deteriorate over time. Now, usually comic book bags are not made of Mylar. They're made of polyurethane or some other type of plastic. And unfortunately, over time, these traditional comic book bags deteriorate. They kind of melt sometimes. I don't want to make it sound like they melt, but they break down over time. And the MyLites and Mylar bags don't. So in order to preserve the comic book inside the bags, usually especially with Silver Age, Golden Age, and Bronze Age comics, I will transfer them from these traditional comic book bags that I got them in into MyLites to make sure that they aren't damaged further over time. So what I'm going to do now is just sort of show my process for transferring a comic from a traditional bag to a MyLite bag, and just how I do it. The way you might do it is could be different, but this is the way I have found it to be best for me, just because I like things simple. And I try to find the simplest way to do things. So this is how I figured it out. Anywho, what you need a comic book. Here's one right here. You need some MyLites, which I have right here. You need some scissors, which I have here. And you need some double-sided removable tape, which I have here. Now this tape is photo safe tape, which means it's archival and it's acid free, which is what you want because you're going to be dealing with a comic book, a paper product, and acid is bad for paper. It's what the reason why a lot of these comic books yellow and get brittle with time is because the paper they're printed on is acid heavy. They have a lot of acid inside the paper, and the acid is what makes the comic book or magazine or whatever break down over time and yellow and start to crack and all that other good stuff. So you want to put it in a product like a MyLite or a Mylar bag that is acid free, that will not interact badly with the paper inside the bag. So with that in mind, I also use tape that is acid free and archival so that, again, over time, it won't deteriorate and possibly hurt the comic book inside the bag. So I use an acid-free bag here, acid-free tape here, and then put the comic book inside the bag and seal it up. So that is my process. And let me just show you what I do, and then you let me know your thoughts, okay? So first step. You want to take the comic book out of the bag without damaging it further. So flip it over, open it up. Now you got this tape here. This is a danger zone. If the comic book, especially a comic book as old as this one, if it catches onto this tape here, it's going to tear. It's going to tear the comic book and really damage it. So what you want to do is, even before you take the book out of the bag, flip it over, take the tape, and sort of curl the tape so that it's sticking to the bag itself. Oh, if I can do it. There, like that. So it's out of the way, and it can't possibly touch the comic book that you're about to slide out. Okay? Now, once you've done that, You want to take the comic book. Don't grab the comic. You want to slide your hand underneath the board. And then with your hand underneath the board, slide the whole thing out, holding onto the board like that, so that the book never leaves the board. Because especially with this book, if you look at it, you can see how broken it is, how cracked it is all along the whole comic book, all those cracks, and it is as brittle as it looks. It's kind of in the danger zone here. So you need to be careful. Here, a piece is already cracked off, and you have folds here. There's a lot of damage. You have some stains, like right there. Staining. This book has seen better days. So you want to be careful, make sure you don't damage it further. All right, now, with the comic book out of the bag, you want to move that to the side, the old bag to the side, and you want to take the MyLite bag here, slide one out, and make sure you get the right bag. See here, this tells you the size of the bag. It says 50 standard comic book size bags. Now, MyLites come in different sizes. They come in standard size. They also come in Golden Age and Silver Age size. Get the standard size if you're going to be bagging anything from Silver Age on up to Modern Age. Because I bought the Silver Age and Golden Age bags. They're too big. They won't fit inside of a standard comic book box. Because they're made to be big enough to hold a Golden Age book, which is bigger than a Silver Age or Bronze Age or Modern Age book. So you need to get the standard comic book size MyLites for any book that's newer than Golden Age. So keep that in mind. That way you'll save money. You won't make the same mistake I did and buying bags that you don't need. All right, so let me try to slide one out. Got one. I got one, here it is. These are great bags. They're crystal clear so that whatever comic book you put inside of it will look much better than they do in sort of the standard comic book bags, which can tend to get cloudy with age. These MyLites will not. All right, now, once I have this, the MyLite, you wanna take your comic, still on the board, and check it. See if there are any areas that are like here. I want to be careful because I'm scared I'm going to damage it further. What if I do? Oh, well. See there's like a dog ear. You want to fold that over so it's in the right place. And do it gently. Because this thing is so old and so fragile, you could easily break it off accidentally. I don't want to do that. All right, it's kind of in the right place. The key is to keep it there while I slip it into the MyLite bag. So I'm gonna lay this down on the table, and then let me just make sure it's oriented in the right place. This is the front. You have let's see, where's the hole? It's hard to see because it's so clear. All right, there's a hole. All right. So let me flip it over so I can slide this comic book in without hopefully damaging it further. It can be tricky. So try not to dog ear it. Try to center that. Slip it in. And then, again, I don't know if you can see this because I can't see the camera, but make sure that little dog ear is down. There we go. And then, come on. down. Looks like it's down. Slide it in. There we go. Like that. Slide it all the way down. Is that? Okay. It looks to be pretty good. Tap it a little. There we go. Like that. Can you guys see that? There you go. Now, it is in the protective sleeve for the MyLites. And it's safe and secure. Now, to seal it with a traditional comic book bag, you would pull the flap over and then tape it. I don't like that, at least for the MyLites, because whenever you try to open it again, it's sort of hit or miss whether or not the tape will snag on the bag, damage the bag, or what have you. So I found the easiest way to prevent that is to use this removable tape, which is made to be adhered to, then removed, then adhered to, and removed. It's made to be taken off and put back on again. So I thought it was perfect for a comic book bag, which the whole point of it is to open and close the bag multiple times so you can have access to the comic book. So what I do is I take, once I have the comic book inside the bag, flip the bag over with the comic book inside, press all the air out, and then take some tape. You want to cut off 3 equal pieces of tape, and you're going to put the pieces equidistant along the flap. So let me show you. Okay, that's 1. The pieces shouldn't be too long, you know. Let's see. 2. 1 more. And let's see. Make sure it's on camera. 3. All right, we got 3 pieces. That's what we want. Put this down. You got 3 pieces of tape here. All right, now you take the tape. It's tacky on both sides. You want to take one side, play with it in your hand a little just to remove the tackiness, because what you're going to do is once you put it on the flap, you're going to flip the flap over and adhere it to the body of the bag, and then you want to peel it off so that the tape stays on the body of the bag. So that there's no chance that if you ever take the comic book out of the bag, the comic book will ever touch the tape, because the tape won't be on the flap. The tape will always be on the back of the bag instead of the flap. I'll just demonstrate it so it's sort of clear. So you take the tape, put it on the flap. That's one piece there. I don't know, can you see that? Hopefully you can. It's one piece there. Take the second piece of tape, you know, place it in the middle, like that. Take the third piece of tape and place it on the other end of the flap, like this. Like that. There you go. All right. Now you got 3 pieces of tape on the flap, equidistant to each other. 1, 2, 3. Now you want to peel off the backing of each piece of tape. Now use your fingernail. Be careful not to peel the tape off the bag. So you got, it's 1 piece, 2 pieces, and then last piece. Is that coming up? It's hard to tell. It's not. All right, let's try again. There we go. I think. Nope. Let's try this end. There we go. All right. Now we got 3 pieces of tape exposed, if you can see that. 1, 2, 3. Now what you want to do at this point, now you take the flap and you bend it over and you place it on the body of the bag and you press down so that the tape transfers from the flap onto the body. Because what you want is that when you peel the flap off the body again, the tape stays stuck on the body, which is what I'm going to do now. So right now, it's sealed. You can still see the tape, I think. One, two, and three. Now I'm going to peel the flap off, and hopefully the tape will stay on the body, and will stay there. Let's see. So I peeled off carefully. One. All right, the first one worked. See, is that gonna work? Two, second one worked. Let's see, three, third one worked. Okay, there we go. This is how you want the tape to be. You got the flap here, perfectly clear. There's nothing on it. The tape is now on the body of the bag. One, oh, can you see? See, one, two, and three. So that if I ever wanna take this comic book out, if I ever wanna slide it out, I don't have to worry about it snagging on the tape, on the flap, like it would on a traditional comic book. It's always going to be on the back of this bag, away from the comic, and that's what you want. You want to protect this comic as much as possible, and part of that involves making sure it doesn't come anywhere near the tape that's sealing the comic book. So that's why I put it on the flap first, then transfer it onto the body of the bag, and then you're safe. And then if you want, again, when you want to close it again, you just take the flap again, and then just put it and seal it, and you're good, you know? And I always make sure to press down, make sure all the air inside the bag is out. So, and that's it, you're done. You got a nice comic book with protection from acid and other stuff, and it's in a nice MyLite bag. It looks good, and you're good to go. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this to my other Silver Age books, and I tend to do this with Silver Age books and some Bronze books, Bronze Age books, and also any valuable books I have. I'll put them in MyLites, just because, again, acid is the enemy, and some of the polyurethane comic book bags are not exactly the best for super long-term storage of comics. So I want to make sure they're transferred into bags that won't damage the comics in the future. So anyway, that is my process for transferring comics into MyLites. So if you guys have any questions, please feel free to ask. I'll be happy to try to answer them if I can. And I'll leave links down in the description below for where to get this stuff. I get it on Amazon for the most part, but I'll leave some links down below for easy access for you guys. Okay, so that's it. I'll talk to you guys later. Take care. Enjoy your day and go read some good comics. Okay? Take care. Bye.